So Microsoft just announced something pretty significant about Windows 10. Even though support officially ends on October 14th, 2025, you can now get another full year of security updates completely free. But there is a catch. And this catch might actually be really convenient for some people, but for others, it might be something that they don't want to do. So right here in Microsoft's announcement, they make it clear that Windows 10 support ends on October 14th, 2025. But now they're offering what they call Extended Security Updates, or ESU, that runs from October 15th, 2025 through October 13th, 2026. So that's exactly one additional year of security updates. Now here's what's interesting about this. Microsoft originally said that they'd offer these Extended Security Updates for $30 per computer. But now they're also giving people two ways to get them for free. Now this tells me that Microsoft might be getting pretty worried about how many people are still using Windows 10. And according to the StatCounter data that Microsoft references, as of May 2025, Windows 10 still has a 53% market share globally. So that means more than half of all Windows users are still on Windows 10, with Windows 11 at 43%. So that's potentially over 500 million computers that would become unsupported. So Microsoft is clearly trying to avoid a situation where hundreds of millions of computers suddenly become vulnerable to security threats. And this extended security updates program is basically their way of buying time so people can either upgrade to Windows 11 or buy a new computer. So according to Microsoft's official documentation here, you have three ways to enroll in the extended security updates program. The first two are completely free, so you can either use Windows Backup to sync your PC settings to the cloud, or you can redeem 1,000 Microsoft reward points. And then the third one, you can make a one-time purchase of $30. So let me break down what that first option actually means. Windows Backup is Microsoft's newer cloud syncing feature that saves your files, settings, and some app data to OneDrive. And if you turn this on, Microsoft will give you the extended security updates for free for 1 year. But here's the thing though, with both the free methods, you need to sign in with a Microsoft account on Windows. And with the Windows Backup option, it means you're uploading all of your data to Microsoft's cloud. Now, if you already have a Microsoft 365 subscription and you're using OneDrive, this might be actually pretty convenient for you. Now, the second option is the Microsoft reward points. And if you've been using Bing for searches or you use Xbox or the Microsoft Store, you might already have some of these points. You need 1,000 points, and according to what I'm seeing, it's actually pretty easy to get these points really quickly. So if you go to the Microsoft Rewards website, you can see the different ways to earn points. And these are usually pretty simple tasks like doing searches on Bing, taking quizzes, or trying out Microsoft products. So 1,000 points is definitely achievable if you're willing to spend a little time on it. Now, what's interesting about this new announcement from Microsoft is that they say that you can use these extended security updates on up to 10 devices with one account. Now, according to Microsoft here, the enrollment process is pretty straightforward. Right now, it's only available to Windows insiders, but starting in July, they're going to roll it out to all Windows 10 customers with broad availability expected by mid-August. Now, here's the important part. This only applies to Windows 10 22H2 that has the latest updates installed. So if you're still running an older version of Windows 10, you need to upgrade to 22H2 and make sure that you have all of the latest updates installed. So if you want to check what version you're running, the easiest way is just to right-click on the Start button and then click on System, and then you can look for the version number here. You want to see that it says 22H2. If you see something like 21H2 or older, you'll need to run Windows Update so you can upgrade to 22H2, or you'll need to do it manually with Windows Installation Media and then install all of the latest updates for 22H2, and then you'll be able to enroll in the extended security updates. Now, let me be clear about what these extended security updates actually include. Microsoft specifically states that ESU only provides critical and important security patches. So you're not getting new features and you're not getting technical support. You're just getting patches for security vulnerabilities. Now, for some people, that might actually be a good thing, considering all the bugs that Microsoft introduces with new feature updates in Windows. But here in this article, Microsoft references the Microsoft Security Response Center, which defines what qualifies as critical and important security updates. So this is going to be patches for vulnerabilities that could allow malware infections, data breaches, or remote code execution. The really serious stuff that you definitely want to have patched. Now, if you're a business, the pricing is quite a bit different because Microsoft is charging $61 per device for the first year, and the cost goes up each year if you want to renew. So for businesses, the free consumer option like using Windows Backup or Microsoft Reward Points is not available. So the question is, should you stay on Windows 10 and enroll in the Extended Security Updates program, or should you just bite the bullet and install Windows 11? And here's my honest recommendation. It's going to depend on your specific situation. First, if your computer can run Windows 11 and you don't need Windows 10 for some sort of legacy software that you use, I'd honestly just recommend upgrading to Windows 11. And you can check this using Microsoft's PC Health Check tool, which will tell you if your hardware meets the requirements. If your computer is compatible, upgrading to Windows 11 gives you much longer support, new features, and better security overall. I've also made other videos on this channel showing you how you can upgrade to Windows 11 even if your computer doesn't meet the requirements, and I'll also link those in the description down below. But if your computer doesn't meet the Windows 11 hardware requirements, or you've tried upgrading it using the bypass methods but it just failed, or you have certain software that just doesn't work on Windows 11, then the extended security updates for Windows 10 makes a lot of sense. But it's only a temporary solution that gives you more time to plan your next move without leaving your computer vulnerable to security threats. Now here's the thing though, you don't have to decide right now. Microsoft says that you can enroll anytime until the program ends in October 2026. So you could wait and see how the rollout goes, or you could wait until closer to the October 2025 deadline to make your decision. And remember, right here, Microsoft states that this enrollment wizard will start rolling out to Windows 10 customers in July with broad availability by mid-August. So if you don't see the option in Windows Update yet, it's probably just not available for your computer yet. And at the time of this recording, it's not available for my Windows 10 computer yet, even after joining the Windows Insider program. But once it's available, I'll definitely make an updated video about this subject, showing you exactly how you can use the two free methods to enroll in the Windows 10 Extended Security Updates program. Now, what I find really interesting about this whole thing is that Microsoft is kind of admitting that the Windows 11 adoption hasn't gone as quickly as they'd hoped, when basically half of all Windows users are still using Windows 10, even though Windows 11 was released almost 4 years ago. That definitely tells us something about either hardware compatibility or user satisfaction. But if you want my recommendation, I've been running Windows 11 for more than a year now, and if your computer can run Windows 11, I do suggest that you upgrade to it. However, I do manage the updates on my computer so that the feature updates aren't automatically installed as soon as Microsoft releases them. The bugs usually come with the feature updates that Microsoft releases. But if you can't upgrade to Windows 11, then you definitely need to take advantage of the extended security updates that Microsoft has just made available for free for consumers. Now, I've also linked Microsoft's article in the description down below if you want to have a closer look at that. But if this video was informative, I'd really appreciate a like and subscribe to the channel. It really helps out the channel and it lets me know that you want to see more content like this. And if you want to see if your computer can be upgraded to Windows 11, you can check out this video right here. And as always, I just want to give a special shout out to all of my YouTube members. Thanks so much for your support. I really appreciate it. And I'll talk to all of you guys soon.